Remember your evacuation training. And yet I'm going deeper into the facility.
The enrichment center is currently being bombarded with fireballs, meteorites, or other objects from space. Please avoid unsheltered testing areas wherever a lack of shelter from space debris does not appear to be a deliberate part of the test.
All right. I guess that's a good tip. All right, this room. This is where we start to get a few different test chambers to actually go through. So what we want to do is we want to press that switch, get that cube. Where are you? There you are. So I guess I ought to get into the controls of this game real quickly. So A button jumps, pretty standard. Before I go any further, I should point out that I am using the Xbox 360 version, so if you're using the PS3 version or something, your controls might be a little bit different. So A button jumps, B button crouches, X button is for activating objects as well as picking up objects, and with the portal gun, you just use it by pulling the right trigger or the left trigger. You can also zoom using the RB button. Zoom was not a feature of the original Portal. It's new to this game, and it is actually quite useful. Oh, wait. I'm stupid. I haven't set up a portal yet for that box to go through. Got a little ahead of myself there. That's kind of a problem. If you really start to know the puzzles and everything, you can sort of get ahead of yourself in terms of solving it. Like, you might try to go a little too quickly.
Well,
open sesame.
The enrichment center reminds you that although circumstances may appear bleak, you are not alone. All Aperture Science personality constructs will remain functional in apocalyptic low-power environments of as few as 1.1 volts.
I don't know, given how some personality constructs behave, I think I'd rather be alone. GLaDOS, anyone? Wheatley doesn't seem like too bad of a guy, though. Alright, moving on.
This next test applies the principles of momentum to movement through portals. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you.
I love that. Luckily for us, the laws of physics very much still apply, and this was one of my favorite puzzle types in the original Portal. Portals with momentum! Oh yeah. Like, you just set up a portal way down, set up a portal up there, and just you fall down and the momentum is transferred. And that, okay, once again, trying to move ahead of myself and, really? You, get back up here. I didn't ask you to fall down that pit. Woo! Gotcha.
If you are a non-employee who has discovered this facility amid the ruins of civilization, welcome. And remember, testing is the future, and the future starts with you.
I don't know if I'm somebody you want trying to rebuild civilization. Okay, more momentum puzzles. Down we go. Fail. Try that again. I even love doing that. If you drop in from like a different angle, you'll flip perspective so that you'll be right side up flying through the portal. It's always kind of trippy the way you just flip around in midair. Someone dig up Isaac Newton. I would love to show him this game. I wonder what he would have to say about it. His head would probably explode. Next puzzle.
To ensure that sufficient power remains for core testing protocols, all safety devices have been disabled. The Enrichment Center respects your right to have questions or concerns about this policy.
I don't think this place was very much safe to begin with. Let's see. This looks like one of those rooms that had the old ball launcher. I forget the name of it. What was it, some kind of orb or whatever? That's not in this game. That's replaced with something else.
You did find a portal gun. Do you know what? It just goes to show, people with brain damage are the real heroes in the end, aren't they, at the end of the day? Brave. Pop a portal on that wall behind
there. Sure, Wheatley. All right. Our old buddy Wheatley has caught up to us. I love this part.
Okay, listen, let me...
You're going to hear me say that a lot.
They told me never, never, ever to disengage myself from my management rail or I would die. But we're out of options here, so get ready to catch me, all right, on the off chance that I'm not dead the moment I pop off this thing. On three. Ready? One. Two. Three! That's high. It's too high.
Chicken. Come on, buddy. I'm here. I'm here for you. I'll catch you. Don't worry. Actually, you can't catch him. Even if you stand directly under him, even if you press the X button or whatever, you're not going to catch him.
I can't move then. That's the problem there. Are you still there? Could you pick me up?
Yeah, it looks like you've got a mobility problem, my friend.
Plug me into that stick on the wall over there, yeah? And I'll show you something. You'll be impressed by this.
All right, impress me. Do it.
Yeah, I can't do it if you're watching. Seriously, I'm not joking. Can you just turn around for a second? All right, you can turn around now. Bam! Secret panel. Got it open while your back was turned. Pick me up. Let's get out of here.
If you say so.
Look at this. No rail to tell us where to go. Oh, this is brilliant. We can go wherever we want. Hold on, though. Where are we going? Seriously. Hang on, let me just get my bearings. Just follow the rail, actually.
All right, now we are in the backstage, if you will, for Aperture Science. What I want to know is, I don't know if it's ever delved into, maybe in some kind of side material, how did GLaDOS wind up back in here? Because she very clearly escaped at the end of Portal 1, so how did she end up back in here? Did she have nowhere else to go and she just decided, oh, I'll just come back here?
Oh, no. Yes, hello, no real stopping. Don't make eye contact, whatever you do. No, thanks, we're good. Keep moving.
The old turret. All right. Now we're about to become reacquainted with an old friend. A very old friend.
In order to escape, we're going to have to go through her chamber, and she will probably kill us if she's awake. If you want to just call it quits, we could just sit here forever. That's an option. Option A, sit here, do nothing. Option B, go through there, and if she's alive, she'll almost certainly kill us. So, if you've got any reservations whatsoever about this plan, now would be a tremendous time to voice them. Right now. In case you thought to yourself, I've missed the window of time to voice my reservations. It's still open.
I would love to know just how many lines of dialogue Wheatley has, because he just seems to have so many. I wonder if he ever runs out. So does this place look familiar? It's a little run down, but this is actually the chamber for GLaDOS from the original game. This was where we actually dealt with GLaDOS in the boss battle.
I don't want to do it. I don't want to go in there. Don't go in there. She's off. She's off. Don't panic over it. She's off. All fine. On we go.
What a mess. There's the old broad.
There she is. What a nasty piece of work she was, honestly. Like a proper maniac. Do you know who ended up taking her down in the end? You're not going to believe this. A human. I know. I wouldn't have believed either. Apparently this human escaped and nobody's seen him since. Then there was a sort of long chunk of time where absolutely nothing happened. And then there's us escaping now. So that's pretty much the whole story, up to speak. Don't touch me.
Yeah, about that human. That human was a she, and you're talking to her right now. Not that Wheatley would know that, of course. Wheatley's a little, he's got a few screws loose. Not too quick on the uptake at times. Still a great character, though, and I am stuck. I got stuck. There's the old incinerator that we used in the final battle against GLaDOS in the first game.
Okay, down these stairs. Jump! Actually, look at it. Oh, still held! Still being held. That's a great job. You've applied the great world fight. That's tremendous.
We shouldn't be able to survive a fall like that, but luckily Chell has these little shock absorber things attached to her shoes. I forget the official name, but it allows her to fall long distances. And I guess that's where we need to go.
This is the main breaker room. Let's go in.
Well, no sense in turning back. We've come this far, right?
Look for a switch that says escape pod. All right, don't touch anything else.
Damn, that's a lot of switches.
Don't even look at anything else. Just, well, obviously you've got to look at everything else to find the escape pod. But as soon as you look at something, if it doesn't say escape pod, look at something else. Look at the next thing, all right? But don't touch anything else or look at
it. I shouldn't do that. I was making myself dizzy.
Can you see it anywhere?
Shouldn't have spun around like that.
Tell you what, plug me in and I'll turn the lights on.
All right. Do your work, little buddy. Now watch what happens here.
We're probably fine, as long as it doesn't start, you know, moving up. Now, escape pod.
Oh, we're gonna move up, all right.
Okay.
And on the way, we're gonna hit every damn lever.
No, makes it go faster.
And we're gonna see the consequences of that right now.
Power up, initiate.
Okay, don't panic. All right, stop panicking. I can still stop this. There's a password. Okay, it's fine. I'll just hack it. Not a problem.
Wheatley, you might want to take a good look at what's taking place in the middle of this room here. Ladies and gentlemen, guess who's back?
Oh, it's you.
You know her?
It's been a long time. How have you been? I've been really busy. After you murdered me.
You did what?
Oh shit.
Oh, no.
We're busted.
No.
Okay, look. We both said a lot of things that you're going to regret. But I think we can put our differences behind us. For science. You monster.
See ya, Wheatley. And as for us.
Since you went to all the trouble of waking me up, you must really, really love to test. I love it too. There's just one small thing we need to take care of first.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bitch is awake. We have awakened GLaDOS from her slumber. And, that's not a good thing. And we're right back to square one. We are now back in the old aperture. Stuck the landing, at least.
The incinerator room. Be careful not to trip over any parts of me that didn't get completely burned when you threw them down here. The dual portal device should be around here somewhere. Once you find it, we can start testing, just like old times.
Yeah, old times. Yeah, sure. Now this is actually the old incinerator room from the first game where GLaDOS first tried to kill us after we were done with testing. Like, the final test chamber ended with us being taken into the old incinerator. Ah, here we go.
There.
All right, here we go.
Good. You have a dual portal device. There should be a way back to the testing area up ahead.
So this is the dual portal device. This is the fully powered up portal device. Now we can create both orange and blue portals, and I do like this touch that they added for the sequel. Whenever you launch a portal, the color of that portal will be shown on your portal gun. Like, it'll either be glowing orange or blue. This can help you in case you're confused as to which portal you set down last. Very, very helpful. Could have used that in the original game, because there were times in the original game where I would get my portals mixed up sometimes. So let's get out of here.
Once testing starts, I'm required by protocol to keep interaction with you to a minimum. Luckily, we haven't started testing yet. This will be our only chance to talk.
You want to talk about football? NFL playoffs start this weekend. The wild card games will probably be done by the time this video's up, but still. Go Steelers! Alright, moving on.
Here, let me get that for you. Do you know the biggest lesson I learned from what you did? I discovered I have a sort of black box quick save feature. In the event of a catastrophic failure, the last 2 minutes of my life are preserved for analysis. I was able, well, forced really, to relive you killing me again and again, forever. You know, if you'd done that to somebody else, they might devote their existence to exacting revenge. Luckily, I'm a bigger person than that. I'm happy to put this all behind us and get back to work. After all, we've got a lot to do, and only 60 more years to do.
60 years? Oh, shit. Like, I love GLaDOS here because she's going to be so passive-aggressive the whole time, like, about not wanting revenge. Believe me, she wants revenge. And she's going to enjoy it at making us go through the testing chambers here. Speaking of which, this is actually one of the older test chambers. This was actually test chamber 19 in the original game, which was actually the final test chamber we went through before we went through the incinerator. So, once again, going through the ruins of old Aperture. Even says so on the wall. Test chamber 19.
I'll just move that out of the way for you. This place really is a wreck. But the important thing is you're back. With me. And now I'm on to all your little tricks. So there's nothing to stop us from testing for the rest of your life. After that, who knows? I might take up a hobby. Reanimating the dead, maybe.
Okay. You don't plan on reanimating me, do you? Assuming that I die before we do all your little tests. Alright, so this elevator here actually marks the end of Chapter 1. Once we go down this elevator, we will go into Chapter 2 of Portal 2. So I think this is going to serve as a nice stopping point. That is a wrap on this recording of Portal 2. We have gone through Chapter 1, the Courtesy Call, and as we move on, we shall see what other things this game has in store for us. So if you folks liked what you saw on this video, please don't forget to like and leave a comment. And if you're new to my channel and you liked what you saw, be sure to subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next recording.